This is Ryan Elliott for Boxing Social and Association with Betfred. I'd like to be joined by Mundo Callum Smith for all the winners' brother Liam's victory this evening. Callum, good couple of weeks for the Smith family. You must be delighted.
Yeah, it's been good. Good, obviously. Happy with my own performance a couple of weeks ago, but this was always the main one for all of us. To be honest, it was the biggest fight, and I'm pleased. Good result. Good fight. Good occasion. The atmosphere was something else in the city, and we kind of expected it. But now it was a good night all round, and we got the result that we wanted. So yeah, as a family, we're pleased.
When I spoke to you, I spoke to Liam, I spoke to Joe McNally this week, you all told me you expected Anthony to make a fast start and Liam to slowly take over. Is that pretty much what you expected tonight?
Yeah, to be honest with you, I thought Liam started slow, but I think, again, Fowler started pretty well, which we kind of knew. He's an Olympian, he's a combat gold medalist, he's a good fighter, he's a good boxer at range, very, very long arms, and I think under Shane, he's back doing what he was good at in the amateurs, so we knew the first four would be tough for Liam. Fowler started pretty quick, and I think with the cut as well, it kind of were the best to start for Liam. But then, no, after the four rounds, I think the fight started to settle and Liam started having a little bit more success. And I think he was making Fowler fight at a pace he didn't want to fight at, which was part of the plan. He was keeping him moving a lot. He was throwing when he didn't want to throw. And then obviously Liam landed. I think the first knockdown was a heavy knockdown, and full credit to Fowler for getting up from it. And fighting back showed toughness, so fair play to him. And I know, thankfully, Liam got the finish a couple of rounds later, I think it was.
When Liam was hurt quite early by Anthony, what was going through your head there? Were you still confident that he had the composure to regain himself?
Not really, no. Nah, yeah, listen, I think he fired lands a few good shots early on. I think Liam kind of knew it was a little bit too early to go for him. I think he fired started pretty well. And Liam didn't look himself, but yeah, I can't really say that without, you know, you've got to credit Fowler for it. He had a good start and he probably stopped Liam getting in his rhythm early on, but I think once Liam found it, the fight became more Liam's type of fight, and that's when he took over. But yeah, it was a fast start from Fowler, and it wasn't the best for us sitting watching it, but deep down I was kind of confident Liam would make his way in the fight. Just with the cut and stuff, I just didn't want him to fall too far behind and then be chasing the fight, and you know, Fowler could then walk him on to top shots. But again, I'll have to watch it back, but I think as a neutral, it was a pretty decent fight, and I say, oh, thankfully we got the result.
You've been here a fight, you've headlined here yourself. I've been here watching you headline. Where did that atmosphere rank among the best you've seen in Liverpool?
Yeah, it was a very, very good atmosphere. I think Liam was saying then he can't wait to watch his ring walk back. It was, you know, as far as ring walks go, it was a good one, and you know, the atmosphere was great. And we kind of expected it. We knew Liverpool fans are great. They always back their own, and we knew Liam done a lot of tickets and had a lot of support, and it's good. But no, a good ring walk, you've got to go in and back it up, and I think he did. He got the result he wanted. It's no good having a good ring walk and then leaving as a loser. So it's been a good night. It's been a good week. We've had a good week. No, fight weeks are only a bit stressful, but this one's been a good one as a team. We got on pretty well, and we got the result that finished off and replicated the camp. Really had a very good camp, and we were saying that coming in. And it's an old cliche, everyone says it, but this camp went fantastic, and I think it's no show with the result.
All right, Callum, final one. What do you want next for your brother? You talked about Jesse Vargas. Do you want that Las Vegas fight, maybe?
Yeah, we'd love a Vegas fight. I think he just wants probably what he was calling for before this fight. He just wants a big fight with a decent name, maybe a fan-friendly one, or just somewhere, a fight with a bit of meaning that's going to put him closer to the world title shot. That's what he wants. That's what every fighter wants, and he's been there before, and you know, he believes he can get there again. Otherwise, I don't believe he'd still be in the game, and I think tonight showed he's still got the hunger and the desire to do it. And not a fight. I think I didn't hear the interview, but it's saying Eddie's mentioned Jesse Vargas. That's a good fight. He's a big name, and if he can do that over in America, then no, I think the winner of that pushes back on towards a world title shot. So just a fight that means something, and that's got a bit of purpose to moving forward. I feel that's what he needs, that's what he wants, and hopefully that's what he'll get.
All right, Callum Smith, thank you as always. Speaking of Boxing Social, have a great night.